Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. If you're a returning subscriber, thank you so much for coming back. And if you're new here, welcome. And I hope you subscribe and I hope you enjoy the videos here. So today I'm going to talk about foundation brushes. And I think they're so important, especially if you like foundation. Even if you don't like makeup, but you occasionally, you know, put on foundation, maybe for events, it's very, very important to make sure that you have the right foundation tool or foundation brush. So today I'm going to be sharing some of my favorites. I've also included some that I think people use and how they use them, but they might not necessarily be my favorites or the ones I would use generally. So I'm going to start with obviously my favorites and then I'll just go down the list. I have quite a few, they're just on my lap and one has fallen. So let's go. The first one is the Real Techniques Buffing Brush. If you do foundation, if you do makeup, if you just love makeup generally, I am pretty sure you have used this brush at some point. It is one of the best affordable foundation brushes I have ever used. It's actually better than some high-end ones I have used and it's just so good. It has a very weird shape. I wouldn't say weird, it's almost like a dome shape, and this dome shape makes foundation application a dream. And this brush is also multifunctional, so you can use it for foundation, you can use it for blushes, you can use it for powder, but I personally wouldn't use it for any other thing because I don't like, you know, when you dip it into, you know, when you use it for foundation, it's a bit moist and then I don't want to dip it into other products. So I use it mainly for foundation and it's amazing. I've had this specific one since last year. I wash my brushes every week or every 2 weeks and it has remained amazing. You know, the quality is great. The only sad thing is they don't sell this brush on its own. So it always comes in a set. It's a little bit pricey sometimes. So I wait for when it's on offer and that's when I get it. But it is so worth it and it's amazing. The next brush I have is also from Real Techniques and it's kind of similar to the buffing brush and it is none other than the Expert Face Brush. Now, when this first launched, I wasn't really like a big fan of it. I just thought, oh, I wouldn't really like it, but I do. It's slightly smaller compared to the buffing brush, but I feel like it really helps in foundation application because of its smaller. So you can, you know, stipple it a little bit more, maybe in areas where you have hyperpigmentation, and it's kind of a little bit more, I feel like it packs a lot more product, a little bit more than the buffing brush. So it's also one of my favorites, but I still go to the buffing brush every time. But this one is really good. I think you can buy this on its own, which is great. So you don't always have to buy a whole set, you know, if you wanted to replace this. But yes, this is also very affordable. Real Techniques brushes are always so good and very affordable. Okay, so now we're going to even more affordable brushes. So those are you know, like buffing brushes. Another one I have is actually from e.l.f. and this one is actually called the Blending Brush. Now, this is e.l.f. e.l.f. is a really good drugstore brand and I'm so glad that now they sell e.l.f. in drugstore in the UK because before you only had to buy it online. It's very, very affordable, very good quality. Actually, the first brushes I ever bought were actually from e.l.f. and I'm talking back in 2011 and some of the brushes I had from there, they're still, you know, still around. I don't use them so much, but you know, it's a really good quality brush. It's also dome shaped, very similar to the buffing brush. And to be honest, I like both of them, but I still like the Real Techniques a little bit more, but this is very good. I like that it's black, so it's easier to keep clean and it washes really easily. All those brushes that I've mentioned, they wash very easily. They're easy to keep clean. But yeah, this is really good. And this is also very affordable. So we have this one, and this is a stippling brush, is it? Yeah. So you can, you probably can't see, but it has a flat top. And this means that it can be used for a lot more products apart from foundation. But I like flat top brushes when it comes to applying foundation, only because it really helps you target areas properly and it can evenly distribute products or foundation when you put them on. It's very easy to use because of the surface area. So you're just going this way and that way. And even if you want to go around in this kind of way, it's very easy with flat top brushes. This one's from Wilco and it's like a store where they sell like home goods and stuff like that in there. So if you don't have a Wilco close to you, there's another brush that's similar to this, which I will show you. So another one, which is similar to a flat, to the stippling brush, which I showed earlier, is the e.l.f. one. And this is another e.l.f. one. So it's a flat topped one. And this is what it looks like black Oh, brushes, they just look so good. With this one, I find that it's a little bit more, the bristles are a little bit softer, which means that sometimes with application, it can be slightly problematic, but I do like this. If you want like a light foundation application, if you don't want a lot of cover, this is really good. And I actually like this, even though I don't use it as often as I should. Okay, so I have another brush, and this is very different. Like I used to use it a long time ago, and then I forgot about it, and I found it again, and I know I'm going to love it. So it's none other than the Sigma Kabuki brush. So it's the 3D HD Kabuki brush, and you can see that the shape is very, very different to all the other brushes I have shown because it has like a curved surface here and here. I think that's why it's called the Kabuki. Now, this is a really good brush because when you put foundation on, even if it's on your face or on the product, because of the curved shapes, it really is very easy to get into, especially all those corners that are very hard, for example, around the nose, around here. Those areas that normal brushes would not be able to get into, this is really good. So in terms of specific application, I think this brush is so amazing. It's from Sigma, so you only have to buy it on, you can only buy it online. I'm sure it's sold in stores. I don't know if it's sold in stores in America, maybe, but this is really good. I really like this as well, and I'm gonna start using it again since I finally found it. We have another brush which I initially thought I wasn't going to like this brush, but I really do, and it is the Fenty foundation brush. As you can see, the shape is very different. It's not a buffing brush, kind of shape, but it is almost like the traditional flat-topped foundation brushes that people use. But this time around, it's actually dome-shaped. So even though it looks flat, it has this nice dome shape on it, and the bristles are super, super soft. This is so good in applying foundation. It's slightly pricier than all the other brushes I have shown, and I actually just bought it as a treat to myself maybe last year or 2 years ago. And it is so good. It really helps your foundation application properly because of the shape and because of how small it is. Again, it's one of those that can get into the nooks and crannies that might be difficult to get into with normal, flat top brushes or, like stippling brushes that are bigger. Because of the size, it gets to so many corners, and I really, really like it. I'm talking about the bristle size, not the actual size of the brush, because it's quite a long brush. But yeah, it's nice. I like the color, a nice pale pink. But it is a little bit more expensive than the other ones I have shown. And now I'm going to talk about regular brushes. So when I first ever used to put foundation, I just assumed that these are the brushes that are best. I know people still use them, and this is a flat brush. It's like a spatula, but yeah, no, it's a flat brush. And I think that most people, especially people who might not be foundation experts, or even people who are foundation experts, they prefer to use flat brushes like this, because when you think about it, in terms of like applying the initial foundation all over your face, this might actually be good. But in terms of blending, I don't think flat brushes are very good at blending, unless you're a makeup artist and you know the technique and all that. I'm not a makeup artist, but I find this takes a little bit more time, to be honest. So it's not my favorite. I actually use this kind of brush to apply masks or scrubs or things like that, and it applies really well. But in terms of blending, it's not my fave. So yeah, this one's from Body Shop. I think I have a similar one as well. I have two. This one I think is actually a blush brush. But yeah, I'm not a fan of flat top brushes, except maybe you're doing someone else's makeup, or you're a makeup artist, or you just want to apply and then you blend later with something else. And then this is my final foundation brush. This is my least used and my most expensive brush, and it is none other than the Marc Jacobs. It's called the Phase 3. I really honestly wanted to love this foundation brush, but I don't think it delivered as much as I wanted it to. It is, I like the idea of it because it's a shorter brush. It has a nice surface area. It's more portable to take, and it has beautiful bristles. And again, it has that dome shape. But I think it's too dense to the point where when you're like working the foundation into your face, it's almost like a lot of work. And I don't know, maybe I'm not using it correctly. Really, maybe I'll look again, look at tutorials and see if there's a way this brush can be more useful. But yes, I've actually had it for like 2 years, and every time I think, you know, we'll get on well and I bring it out and I'm just like, no, like, it's not for me because I don't know, but I can't let it go because of the cost. But yeah, it's still a good brush, I guess. I mean, you can use it for other things, but in terms of foundation, it doesn't personally work for me. This is my final foundation brush, and it's from Cover FX, and it is called the Custom Blending one. I actually got this on sale sometime in maybe 2018 or 19. I know I was in Scotland anyway, and I saw it was really cheap, but this brush normally is very expensive. I haven't used it a lot. That's just the truth. I think it's one of those brushes that when you use it a little bit more, it becomes more pliable. It becomes easier to use. But at the current time, it's not quite my fave. It looks good, to be honest. It does look good. It has that nice dome shape because that's what I like. I think there's just a little bit too much of the bristles in there. But I'm going to give it another chance and I will report back maybe in a blog post. But it's still, you know, it's still a new brush in terms of me using it as often because I haven't. So I don't think it's very fair to say it's not a great brush. But yeah, I haven't used it a lot. But it's okay. If you still find it and you want to try it, it'll be good. So the final tools I have, and this ones are really popular, and these I really, really like. Sometimes I don't use them as often as I should. They are none other than the beauty blenders or the blending sponges. I think the beauty blender is the trademark for beauty blender. So this is the first one, and this is actually the actual original beauty blender that comes in this little box. I love this. So me, I have tried a lot of beauty blenders. In fact, I'm actually do a video on beauty blenders, but this is still the best. The texture is amazing. It feels really soft. It washes easily. Sometimes it doesn't. I actually got the black one because I cannot deal with dirty brushes. This is so good. I really, really like this. There's another one from Real Techniques, and this is the one. It's called, I think, the Miracle Complexion Sponge or something like that. This is equally good. I think these are my two favorite ones that I have ever used, these two. I think I did a blog post comparing both of them, but I still ultimately like the beauty blender. This is also really good. It's more affordable. This is like £16-15, and this is usually like £6 or so for like two or maybe one. But yeah, it's really affordable, but the material is totally different. You know, I just really like the beauty blender more, but this is so good. When you use beauty blenders, your foundation looks amazing. It's so well blended. You just put it into water, it expands in size, and you can buff in your foundation. The application makes your face look very natural. There are no streaks, there is nothing. It's just so good to use, but obviously you have to keep it clean and wash it off. So yeah, those are my favorite foundation brushes and tools. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, give it a thumbs up, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye-bye.